All right, back to work tonight, guys and gals. Hope you guys had a fantastic Monday out there, but it's time to get back to work. Time is ticking. It's Monday evening. It's October 19th, 2020. My name is Joseph, and as always, welcome back to your nightly newsletter. If you're tuning in for the first time, it's great to have you with me because my job tonight is to help us find the best trade setups for tomorrow. That's Tuesday's trading session. I got a jam-packed video in store for you guys tonight. Course charts are all prepped up in the background. As you can see, got the S&P, got the oil, and we got the gold on our radar for tomorrow. Lots of great setups we're tracking for Tuesday's trading session. Before we jump in, though, and get our hands dirty on these charts tonight, I just want to make sure to remind you, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. I don't want you to miss all the good stuff we publish every evening, so make sure you subscribe that we always get that email in your inbox every evening. And don't forget, if you have any questions for me tonight, you can always drop those questions in the comment section below. So drop me any questions, and I'll get them answered as soon as we finish up tonight's video. And as always, if you guys tune in every evening, if you enjoy this video as much as I enjoy making it for you guys every evening here, how about a thumbs up here for us on this video? Really appreciate you guys supporting our channel by subscribing, typing those questions in, and if you love the video, hit that thumbs up button for me. Always appreciate you guys tuning in every evening. But enough of the introduction, though. Let's get this video going. As you can see in the background here, charts are all prepped up in the background here for us. Boy, gold. Start with gold today. Gold looking at a range for tomorrow. Would like to look for sell short above the top of that range tomorrow. My big concern on the gold, though, is momentum. And as the market swings back higher, I'd love to get short up around that battle zone up there. We're going to dig into more detail on the gold here tonight's video. Over on the oil, oil is really a flat range-bound market right now. I want to buy low. I want to sell high on oil. I've got this expanding triangle on my radar for oil trading tomorrow. So we definitely won't be watching for that expanding triangle. Hopefully we'll get a full rotation back up. We're going to dig into that more in detail in tonight's video. And then of course you can see on the S&P, right? The S&P, a bloodbath on the E-mini here today. I'll tell you, wouldn't be surprised if we see a nice 1-2-3 reversal and right back up to that 64.75 area. Might be time to look for a reversal here on the S&P. I'm going to put together a plan for the E-mini traders here for tomorrow. So S&P's ready, oil is ready, gold is ready. The hardest one's probably gonna be gold here for tomorrow. Before we jump in, though, and get these charts prepped up, though, let's make sure we check the calendar for tomorrow as we look at the rest of this week here. It's the fourth week of the month of October, so it will be a little bit of a light news week this week, right? Usually the first week, third week, and the final week. This is kind of that in-between week right now. So fourth week of the month, we do anticipate this to be a little bit of a lighter news week. There's plenty of news here this week, but you'll notice not as much as we normally would have. Tomorrow, of course, is a Tuesday. As we look closer at the schedule for tomorrow, we can see the big news report coming out, 8:30 Eastern time, is that housing starts in permits. And of course, tomorrow we get the first World Series game, right? Go Dodgers here. I live in Los Angeles. Great to have some local teams, right, doing well this year, right? Lakers did well. Dodgers, of course, right, back to the World Series as well. I don't think that will affect us too badly in the financial markets tomorrow. But of course, got game one of the World Series tomorrow night versus Tampa Bay Rays. That'll be pretty exciting to watch on television. But we definitely do have, though, our big news for tomorrow at 8:30 Eastern time. As we look throughout the rest of the week this week, we got the Wednesday petroleum status report. We got jobs and home sales on Thursday and the PMI number at 9:45 on Friday. Don't forget, we got the next presidential debate on Thursday evening this week as well. You know, looking at the news, though, housing starts and permits tomorrow, inventories for oil on Wednesday. It does look like Thursday and Friday are going to be the big news reports that we have scheduled right now. But obviously, there's a lot going on right now, right? We get the election here in the U.S. About 2 weeks away, right? Early, you know, first week in November, we're listening in for more talks about stimulus, right? We're kind of flirting with some ideas of stimulus this week. That's probably the biggest known unknown this week. I don't think anyone's really holding their breath for that debate on Thursday, and I doubt the World Series, as much as I would love to have it affect the markets, I doubt that will affect these markets too much. But I would expect, though, you know, we keep hearing back and forth from the White House on Capitol Hill about some stimulus packages that are in the works right now. That is probably going to be the biggest known unknown as we go throughout the rest of the week. So not a lot of news this week. Again, that fourth week of the month. Big news tomorrow, housing starts. But again, it looks like the really big news we're going to see here on Thursday and Friday this week. Will we hear more about stimulus? That is definitely something we're watching and listening in closely on that. And again, we're only 2 weeks away from the election. Will we get any big bombshell announcements, right? This time last year, the WikiLeaks were lighting everything up this time last year. So we're going to see if we get any October surprises here as we go into the last half of the month of October. So we'll come back and we'll prep up for Wednesday's news in tomorrow night's newsletter. But let's get back to those charts though. Jumping back to our charts here, S&P, oil, and gold. I want to jump first here into the S&P, of course. S&P took a big nosedive, right, in today's trading session. You can see this strong move down here. Now, kind of what happened here today? Well, first of all, you may recall, we went all the way back up to that 3,500 late on Friday, and there was a big profit taking on Friday. And we talked about this morning in the trade room. That profit taking sent the market running lower, and basically what happened was, it looks like everybody bought the dip, right? Opened up on Sunday and gapped up. Well, that weekend gap, you know, the difference between Friday's closing price and Sunday's opening price, remember guys, Sunday evening at 6 o'clock Eastern time is when these futures markets open up, right? They don't wait until that Monday morning. They open up on Sunday evening. That gap right there is the closing price on Friday, and of course creates the gap from the opening price on Sunday. It looks like what happened, the buyers got so excited to buy that dip, they bought it, gapped up, and they just couldn't hold it, right? And it slammed back lower and basically closed that gap. Well, right about that time of the day, we also heard news from the White House that there wasn't a stimulus package that had been agreed upon, right, along with a couple other M&A announcements that fell apart. And you can definitely see that definitely drag the market lower. So we got a pretty strong move down here today. They popped it up, they came back down, filled the weekend gap. I'm going to leave that weekend gap on there for the rest of the week. If you remember from last week, how many times did we keep going back to retest those weekend gaps? Again, I call them weekend gaps. That's really just Friday's closing price. 64 and three quarters, though, is going to be a magnet for the rest of the week this week. So keep that in mind as we go. Now, I talked about a reversal. What would a reversal look like here? Because I definitely think we could see a nice, easy reversal here. What I really hope that we get a chance for the reversal is, I hope we get a chance here to run up, hold a pullback off the moving average, and jump off the EMA. If I can get this one strong move up, two pull back to the moving average, and three jump off, I can grab a new channel off those highs, bring it down off that low, and I can get long off the low of that new hidden channel. Target, of course, will be up at that 64 and three quarters, and you gotta leave a little portion as a runner up to that 34.90 just to kind of run right back to that range, right, we came from at the end of the week last week. So very curious if these buyers are gonna get that pop that they want. That's one thing on my radar right now, is a reversal for tomorrow. But of course, I can't try to predict the reversal, right? That's kind of a fool's game, trying to predict these bottoms. I'll wait for proof of that reversal. Now, how do we sell this market? Because in all reality, it's a bear market right now. Bear market, nice strong bear move down. Anytime we see a strong move like this, you got to be thinking there's going to be a lot of sellers up here trying to get short at an area of resistance, right? You got to think there's probably going to be a level of resistance up there that we can use. And what I can do is I can actually measure the size of this move down, and I can use that for my target on the way going lower. So if I mark up that, if I measure that move down and bring it over here, now that will kind of give me an idea for where that target may be. As of right now, we're kind of speculating on this, but assuming we get a pullback here, that is definitely where that, right, where that next target could easily be for those bears, right? That 33.90, depending on, right, how far they pull back. So again, what I'll look for is, I'll look for a chance to get short up off these areas of resistance, looking for another leg lower. How big would that leg be? Probably going to be about the same size of that leg down from last Friday. And again, right now, we may not know how far the pullback will go, but once we do know how far the pullback goes, we'll be able to project out where those targets are. So what's the best way to get in on this thing? We know we're bearish. We know we'd like to be a seller on this. You know, it's a range, right? It's a range. So, you know, one of the things we always talk about whenever we have a range here is the most important thing whenever you have a range is to focus on failures, right? Focus on failures. Now, there are two types of failures I'm watching for. One is going to be a nice deep, deep pullback. Buyers coming in, buyers trying to buy the pullback off the moving average. And again, if they can hold that pullback and run, now I can mark up a new channel and I can buy the low of that new channel, right? That's called a 1-2-3 reversal pattern. But make no mistake though, it's not a bull market yet, right? If we poke our heads higher and these buyers fail on that pullback, we can sell right into those stop losses. And we can sell the pullback to the moving average as long as we're not getting short inside the range. That's the one kind of rule, right? We want to sell above the range. So buyer failure pattern into a seller pullback pattern. Now, one more thing I'm watching, you'll notice there's a little swing high right there. If I look at that swing high, it's a very strong move down. And there's a good chance that we might see some aggressive sellers that really don't let this thing pop nice and high up here. So what if the market sinks back down again? How could I sell this without selling too low? A shallow pullback here, I'll be looking for traps, right? Traps are my go-to. You know, for example, if we don't get up into these areas of resistance, right? If we don't get up into the top of that channel, if we don't get up into that sell zone overhead, right? Remember, I want to sell at resistance here. If all I get is a really shallow pullback though, then I've got to be concerned about selling too close to that range and look for a trap pattern to get short from there. So it's a relatively straightforward idea here. Strong move down. I'm expecting bears are looking for a retest of low, looking for a potential measured move, going lower here. Do we get that nice deep pullback? Do we see those buyers coming in trying to get long so we can sell into those stop losses? Or do we see a little trap high here? And because of that shallow pullback, I don't want to sell too low. So instead, I look for a trap pattern right above that high. Buyers try once, buyers try twice into a trap pattern. Now, let's be honest too, right? A lot of momentum for those bears. Could I sell this thing as it's going lower? Yeah, I definitely can, but I've got to see what I call an open loop. You've got to open up another one of these big strong moves here. So for example, let's just say, for example, the market tanks, right? Pulls back and jumps off that moving average, that would be another potential 1-2-3 move. I could draw a trend line off that low, off that high, and I can get short off the high of that new hidden channel. So if the bloodbath continues and we continue to roll lower, I'll be looking for that pattern as we go lower. So really it all comes down to how deep of a pullback do we get? Or do we make a run with another strong leg lower and a jump off the moving average, grab that low, grab that high, and we can sell short off of that high as well. So buyer failures, bull traps, and basically 1-2-3 reversals and 1-2-3 breakouts. You know, guys, I teach all the basics of these strategies in our free trading class, right? Believe it or not, I cover all of those patterns I described inside the free trading class. What I'll do is I'll put a link in the upper right-hand corner for you. grab that link, pause the video if you want to, but if you're serious about your trading career, right, or growing your trade account for that matter, make sure you grab that free trading course link in the upper right-hand corner. That way you can learn more about my failure patterns, my trap patterns, and of course my breakout patterns as well. Those are three patterns I'm watching there, right, for the sell side. And again, if we get lucky, maybe we do get that reversal with that 1-2-3 move. Oh, and one more thing too. Don't forget, oftentimes when we do see that jump off the moving average, right? Don't forget, a lot of times what happens is we'll see a shallow pullback, a higher high, and there'll be a little trap down there, right? And you can buy the low of that channel and get in on a trap low there as well. That is probably the best possible scenario we could get for tomorrow, a trap low off the low of that new hidden channel. All we need now is a little more time here, and we'll see what we get here on the S&P. We're bearish. I want to be a seller at resistance. I've got some great areas identified here. Now all we need is to get some entry setups, or maybe we get that full-blown trend reversal. And again, no matter where we pull back, use that first leg, right? And let that be your guide, right? If all we do is pull back up here, right? Now we know how big that final target is on the runner going lower. We'll know more soon here on the S&P. And again, make sure you grab that free trading course, right, like I mentioned up top before. Let's keep going here. Jumping in now here over to our crude oil here this afternoon or this evening. Jumping in here out of the oil, looking at the oil chart here for us. Looking at oil, we of course have a range bound market, right? It's a bull market going higher into what is, I think, pretty easy to see, right? It is a trading range environment here. So we know it's a range. We know there's a little bit of a bull bias to it, right? We definitely can see a little bit of a bullishness there to that trading range. Now, we've talked a lot about these range-bound markets over the past few weeks in this newsletter, haven't we, right? Whenever we have a bull market into a trading range, there are pretty much three patterns I'm looking for, three basic patterns, right? Let's talk about those real quickly, and then we'll look at the chart here for a moment. So bull market up into a trading range, right? Three basic patterns. One, the one I really like the most is find a support level. This is really important here. Find a support level below the range and combine that support level with what I call a failure pattern, right? So wait for the price to pull back. Wait for those sellers to come in. Try to get short off the moving average. Remember, we're looking at support area here, and we can buy right into those stop losses. So that's always my bread and butter when it comes to a range-bound market with a bull bias to it. Remember, it's not just your average range, it's a bull bias range. So buying below the range at a level of support using a failure pattern. Now, there are two breakout patterns we like to use. Remember those from last week? One of them is a 1-2-3 breakout. This will start off with a, and you don't need a big strong breakout, just got to get a jump off the moving average, right? One strong move up, two pull back to the moving average, three jump off the moving average. Now, once you got that, bingo, mark the high, mark the low, and get ready to buy the low of that new hidden channel. The third pattern, the second breakout pattern, is called a two-try breakout. It's a very simple pattern, but it requires a very strong break higher. Once we have that strong break higher, then I look for a shallow pullback, a new higher high, and usually that shallow pullback will just barely kiss the moving average, right? Or it'll barely miss the moving average. That is why this pattern is so powerful, because all the FOMO kicks in. Nobody wants to miss that next leg, and they come in and grab it for a trap off of that, right, off of that low. And again, these are patterns you can combine with channels as we go higher here. So knowing that oil is a bull market into a trading range, we look at three basic patterns, right? I'm looking to buy below the range of support, or buy the breakout with a 1-2-3 breakout, or buy the breakout with a 2-try breakout. Now, let's go back to our chart right now. And that's why I said before, it's very important that you remember the key is to buy at support below a bull range, right? I realize it's a very sideways, very choppy market right now. Boy, they said, was it a million travelers on Sunday, air travel? I'm not sure what the average on that is, but that sounds like a lot of people traveling right now. Hopefully that'll be good news for the oil industry. Boy, they've really taken it on the chin with this pandemic, obviously, because the lockdown and nobody's traveling. Nobody's, you know, just obviously the demand for oil has really been hit. And that's been one of the biggest reasons why we've seen some of these kind of sluggish, sloppy oil markets right now. But the bottom line is we can see the bull market. Right, we can see the bullishness before the range. We can see your range here. Now you'll notice what I've done. Right, I'm taking out my secret weapon when it comes to a trading range. With all kidding aside, obviously, a triangle. Right, an expanding triangle. Now what I want you to see on this is how the market rotates. We go up, we go down, we go up, we go down, we go up. And we should come back down. Now, if we can get back down, there's a good potential, it's a good possibility, we may rotate all the way back up as we go. Now, the big challenge we have on this, of course, is I have to get down right into this area of support, right? I've got to get down into that support area. So I want to be a buyer. I want to buy below the range. I want to look for, as you can imagine, with that trend line down there, what I'd like to do is I'd like to get this thing down into that area, get these bears to come over, get them to try to get short so I can then buy into stops. And then if I'm lucky, I'll look for buys before we get back up into that range. Remember, the only thing is you don't want to trade inside the range, right? You want to look for that seller failure. Remember though, off support, right? That's the trick. When it comes to a range, it's not just buy low, sell high. It's buy low at support below the range. It's sell high at resistance above the range. In this case, though, I want to buy low. I want to find support and buy into a seller failure, into a bullish pullback, and then potentially, hopefully, get that big swing back up to the other side of this trading range. Now, like I mentioned before, support is what we want. You'll notice, if you look closely here, we are technically at a support level right now. Only problem is I don't want to trade too close to that range. So much like the S&P, when I talk about a shallow pullback on the S&P, if all we see is a very shallow pullback here, what happens a lot in these shallow pullback scenarios is you've got to look for traps. Because for example, if we pull, and again, we're sitting kind of that low right now, if we pull back here, and the bears try to get short off the moving average, if I buy into stop losses, am I avoiding the middle? Am I avoiding the range? No, I'm not, because I got to get in above these highs there. That oftentimes will kick back against you. Oftentimes, it'll go up. It'll come right back down again, and that's where you'll be waiting for that trap low. So just kind of keep that in mind. That's kind of that's a little more advanced tactic, but the ideal would be get down into support, wait for those bears to come out and get short off the moving average. That tells you right where those stop losses are, right? Then you can buy into stop losses. You can buy the pullback off the moving average. Just make sure you're not buying that pullback inside the range. That's the one caveat to it, right? You want to buy that pullback back inside that trading range. Or if it's a shallow pullback, think about one try for the bears, two try for the bears, get underneath the range, and get underneath a prior swing. That's the way to trade a very shallow, you know, shallow breakout, so you're not trading too close into that trading range. That'll keep you out of trouble there. Now, as we go higher, right, as we go higher here, where would the buyers be trying to hunt for? Buyers have nice, easy targets overhead. Obviously, we talked about this, right, this expanding triangle. That's a target overhead. That's a target overhead. If you go even further out the ladder here, right, you got that big top up there, 4202. If the buyers really get what they want here this week, we'll be up around 42 here by the end of the week. Now, there's a lot of work to do, obviously, and they're going to need a small miracle to rally these buyers that far. But that is definitely something we're watching for here for those buyers. So let's just say, for example, here, there is a stimulus package that gets approved here on Capitol Hill. Let's say there's also something in there, right, to help out the airlines and the markets really take off to the upside. What would be some patterns I'd be looking for to trade this? First one would be a strong move up, right? Second thing, pull back to the moving average and a jump off the moving average. Now remember, we've seen a couple strong moves higher, but we haven't seen the price jump off the moving average. We've seen a couple good pops, but they've fallen flat, right? They haven't been able to keep the party going here. So we need to see those buyers hold that pullback and really show us some proof on that. Now, I do realize that if we run up, we'll be running into the top of that triangle. But as long as we have that 1-2-3 move, it's almost a certainty. It's about as close to a certainty as you're going to get of being able to buy the low of that new hidden channel for at least a first target and a retest of that new interim high. So 1-2-3 reversal, 1-2-3 breakout into a hidden channel pullback, or if things really start to rip, right, which they could, you know, we talk about stimulus, you know, this is an industry that's been weighed down here for months now. So, you know, again, I'm not saying let's all get long right now, but I'm just definitely saying there's potential this market could take a ride up to that 42. If it really does run, right, now I'm looking for, again, shallow pullback, higher high. Remember, that shallow pullback is the giveaway. The shallow pullback makes it frustrating because buyers are wanting that pullback. If they don't get the entry, they're gonna make sure they put their back into it, right? Put the kitchen sink into it here, right, on that next trap low. That'd be a two-try trap. And as I mentioned before, I will always, always look for hidden channels to combine off of those, again, what I call two-try breakouts or two-try trap patterns, right, in our video course. So we'll definitely keep an eye on those as well. So long trades are definitely on our radar here on Crude. And again, I talk about failures and breakouts. As I mentioned before, I talk about all those patterns inside the free trading course. And keep in mind too, I'll put all the important links you guys need right in the description of this YouTube video. I'll put a link to come out and join us tomorrow morning in our trade room. I'll put the free course links down there, so make sure you grab that right as well. All right, we're looking pretty good here, right? So long trades are also to go. How do we sell short on this? What's the best way to sell short in a bull market that goes sideways? Well, one thing would be we get a reversal, right? If we were to see a strong move down, hold a pullback, and run, right? Almost like what happened in the S&P today, right? S&P had a range, and we saw that strong, right, jump going lower. That's what set things up for the bears in the S&P. That's exactly what we want to see here on the oil. Strong move down, pull back, and run there. And again, we're going to want to see some pretty good strength, right? We're going to want to see this thing really break free of that magnetic field that is a trading range. Remember, what is a range? A range is it's ultimately a magnet on that chart. I've got to get a good distance and some good velocity away from that range. You know, saying velocity makes you think about those SpaceX, right? Those NASA shuttles, right? How do they get them out of Earth's orbit, Earth's magnetic field? They got to use those rocket boosters, right? You got to have a strong jump away. If you don't, it's going to keep on coming right back up into that magnetic field. So, you know, long story short, 1-2-3 breakdown, that momentum will be enough now. Now I can mark that low, I can mark that high, and I can look for a short off of that high, right? Remember, when you have that much momentum turning, there's going to be a ton of sellers who want in on that move. That's what makes that trade, right, so reliable. Where would those bears be trying to go? Where do we think the bears want to go? The bears have one thing on their mind. Yeah, 40, you know, 40 bucks a barrel will be a nice little appetizer for those bears, but they're hunting for that 39.52, right? That big, big move down from earlier in the month. Was it, last Thursday, right? Last Thursday morning. They still have yet to take out those highs yet. So that would be considered what you call an open loop in our trade room, right? Big, strong move down. Wouldn't surprise me at all, right, if the bears take this thing lower here at 39.52. But again, right now, though, it's a little bit tough to call this a bear market right now with that bull push up on Friday into today's trading range. So again, failure patterns, breakout patterns, that's on our radar here for oil. And again, if there's one market that would really love a good stimulus package right now, you're looking at it right here on the oil. So we'll definitely keep our eyes open for any potential breakouts, right? 1-2-3 breakouts and 2-try breakouts going higher here. Let's keep this party going though, right? We got the oil. We got the E-mini. Boy, it looks like the E-mini might be, they might be listening to this video right now as I'm recording it here. You can see a nice little short covering rally right now. Again, would love to see a reversal on that E-mini here. How about some gold, though? Let's wrap things up here tonight with the video on gold here tonight. What do we see here on the gold? So I'll tell you, gold, like I mentioned earlier, gold might be the most challenging of all of the markets we have here tonight, just because it's a tough one. There's nothing really clear except for that range right in the middle there at 1912. Now, I'll be honest, I'm cheating a little bit here. There's actually one big range from last Friday. And again, from before that again, there's pretty much one big range all around this 1910 to 1912 area here. So, there's going to be a magnet here. What do we know about gold right now? Gold had a really strong push higher. And then, boy, what's his name? Our boy Powell, right? Powell came out. He's talking about cryptos this morning. And I'll tell you right now, cryptos might as well be kryptonite for gold, right? I'll tell you, if you're a gold bug, if you're buying lots of gold out there, the last thing you want to hear right now is the head of the Fed here in the U.S. talking about digital currency going forward. No joke. I assume that's what killed this rally, right? A huge rally up here today. And then Powell comes out talking about, well, not Bitcoin, but talking about digital currencies, and gold's like, what? I thought gold was a shelter market. We're supposed to be going to gold next, right? And you can definitely see it. It really kind of let all the wind right out of those sails. All kidding aside, obviously, right? They get that 1, 2, 3 move down. And I'll tell you, when you see a bull market like this that reverses, there is one thing on the seller's mind, and that is bury those lows, right? And what really I think is the biggest tip-off that we know this is a range is because they should have been burying those lows there, right? This market, they should have had no problem finishing off that low. And that's it's not the most obvious range, but it's kind of like what didn't happen. What should have happened, right, did happen. When you see a market lift off like that and then reverse, it should have been pretty much just take my money and run it lower there, right? But it didn't, right? It didn't finish that low here. So that makes me believe now there's a range probably right in the middle there, and a little bit of analysis longer term, and you can see there's a range there around 1910 to 1912. So I won't take up too much more of your time on this, right, describing why it's a range, but I think that the lack of follow through, right, combined with this little tiny double tops, double bottoms right there, flat moving average, if you put a volume profile on this, I can almost guarantee you all the volume be piled up right around right that 912, 911 area there. So that's range will act as a magnet, right? Remember, ranges act like a magnet. Now, you might already be looking at this going, okay, Joe, so what's the plan on this one then, brother? Because you can definitely see, right? Remember, when you have a range with a bear market, it's the same basic idea we talk about for oil for a bull market, but where's the best trades going to be? The best one, my bread and butter on range is always go up above the range. Remember, it's a bear market now, right? Get above the range, look for buyers to try and fail up here at resistance, right? Remember, in a bull market, you want to buy support below the range. In a bear market, you want to sell resistance above the range. And you can see where I've got some trend lines here, got that hidden channel here, right? There's plenty of resistance up there, and that would be a great sell setup off those highs. But you might notice, though, look where we are, right? We're way down here right now. So think what's going to happen when the market pulls back like that. Holy Christmas, that's going to be a really strong move. And so I've really got to be careful. What's going to happen is momentum. Momentum is really potentially the big problem that we have here for sellers on the gold. The other option would be is we have to hold the pullback. If they can hold that pullback, then we can look for a 1, 2, 3 breakout. That sounds good to me too. Mark up the low, mark up the high. Is this making sense out there, right? Is this all making sense? How about a thumbs up? Everything pretty clear here, right? If you have any questions, don't forget, drop those questions in the comment section below, right? This is the opposite of the oil, right? It's a range, but it's bearish, right? Am I making sense out there? For how about a thumbs up if you guys are enjoying the video so far? I hope you subscribe as well here to the channel here, because we put these out every evening, Monday through Thursday. So again, 1-2-3 breakdown. We've already got the strong move down, right? Can we get that follow through for proof and then short that sucker off the high? That would be okay. And then last but not least here, where are they trying to go here? They're trying to go. Look at what space they have down here. I'll tell you, gold. We talked about gold being one of the big opportunities last week, right? Look at that wide open space down there. That's the big bottom, right, from last week. So 1885, that's where those bears are trying to go here. What else could we do here for the bears? Well, we could look for that 2-try breakout, right? So strong move down, shallow pullback, lower low, trap high. Again, these are really incredible patterns. And again, what you want to do is think about, how can I connect a low? How can I connect that high? Wow, right? I mean, that would be the creme de la creme, as they say, right? That would be a very, very powerful setup if we can get all those cards, right, to come together. All right, so that will be some setups we're watching for. But please, though, right, the hard one is the pullback. The hard one is the pullback. The easy ones are the breakouts right now. How do we sell above this high? Here's what I'm thinking. If we make a run back higher again, what's my problem? My problem is not lack of resistance up here. My problem is momentum. And what's the best way to account for momentum? In this case, the bulls got to let them try a couple times, right? Let them try once, let them try twice, and then we can sell back down. Now, these are failure patterns, but they're called nested failures. So let's say, for example, we make a run back higher here, right? Make a nice run back higher here. Now, what I want to do is I want to let these buyers kind of dig their own grave, right? Because they're not going to give up as easily if this thing whips, right? They're not going to give up as easily if this thing really turns over and runs higher. Let them try once, let them try twice. And one of my tricks is always look for traps above that first try high, right? That's a good one to look for, right? Again, it's the same basic idea, right? Buyers trying once, buyers trying twice. If I can find a trap up there, bingo, that's the best entry possible. Another potential entry here could be if it flattens out, right? If it goes up, comes back, buyers try once, comes down, draw that trend line across those highs and look to short off that trend line, right? Same idea, 1-try, 2-try, short off the high there. Does that make sense, right? Again, why am I going through the extra step of 2 tries? Because momentum, right? It's very different than a bear market. You know, think about it, right? Think about the difference between these two. If I have a bear market down, right? If I just pop right back up, momentum's not a big deal, right? I can look for a buyer failure and I can sell right into those stop losses, right? With those buyer failure patterns at the top of that range. But if we go lower though, right? If we go lower and then we start coming up, right? I don't think you have to have a lot of experience to see the difference there, right? That is the difference. That momentum is much different. So now as we go, right? There's my range. We poke lower. As we run higher here, a lot of momentum. Buyers come over. Let them try once. Let them try twice. And again, can we use a trend line to get short, right? Can we get a trap? Right, to get short, or double top, right, to get short. Remember, you always want to try to incorporate some level of resistance at that, right, above that high of that trading range. Another small nuance to this too is sometimes it'll go up, it'll pull back, go once, pull back again, and keep your eyes on a trap. Remember, we don't want to trade inside the range, right? So a little bit more advanced tactic there, but imagine now the price kind of sinks back into the range quickly here. I don't want to just short it because I don't want to trade inside the range. I do want to sell, but I'll sell it again with that trap, right? To avoid what? To avoid selling too close to that trading range. So hopefully that makes sense here. Again, the overall idea here is sell above the top of this trading range, but how we get there means momentum. So 1-try, 2-try, and then back down from there, or a big breakout going lower. Now, how could I buy this market? Could you buy this thing? You definitely can. In fact, these are markets that you could easily get a bullish reversal here off of because of that momentum swinging. So as you can imagine, there's two easy patterns, right? Or maybe not that easy, right? If you're learning for the first time. But first one is a strong move up, pull back off the moving average. You got it. Jump off the moving average, find that new channel, right? And again, get aggressive off the low of that hidden channel, right? You're not going to want to buy the first pullback. It's too bearish right now, right? Not a very reliable setup. Look for the second pullback. Not really the second pullback, just the pullback off the low of that new hidden channel. Or if this thing really gets crazy and really runs, again, watch out for that shallow pullback, higher high up here. Again, if this thing really, you know, it really runs, really strong move higher here, very strong move, shallow pullback, doesn't really give us any pullback, higher high, you got to be thinking at that point, everyone be looking for those buys below that low. Maybe get a chance to use that trend line. Maybe that trend line becomes support, right? So we'll definitely keep that in mind as well. Where is the goal for the buyers? The buyers, they want to get back up to retest those highs at that 1923. And if they really get this thing going, right, 1930 is that big top above, and up to 1939.5 all the way higher here. So probably one of the more challenging markets for tomorrow, right, is the gold. And of course, with the whiff of stimulus in the air right now, gold will likely be potentially one of the big movers here of the week. It's just a matter of getting the right setup to get into it. Hopefully by now, they'll get a good plan here for tomorrow. So will we get that full pendulum swing? Will be reversal? Will be a nested failure? That is definitely on our radar here for tomorrow. Oil, looking to buy the low of that triangle, and the S&P. Are we going to buy? Will the buyers fail or will the buyers hold? That is definitely the big question on our radar for tomorrow. Speaking of tomorrow, the best place to do this is come out and do with me tomorrow morning in the trade room every morning, Monday through Friday. What I'll do is I'll put all the membership links you guys need. I'll put the free course links. I'll put the advanced membership links, the trade room links. I'll put them all in the description of this YouTube video for you. So grab those links in the description. Get registered. Don't be afraid to call me in the office if you have any questions along the way. I'd love to answer all the questions there, so call me in the office. We've also got live chat on the left, live chat on the right. You could literally fall off a horse and find some live chat buttons on our website. So feel free to chat away with us. Be happy to answer all your questions there. By all means, though, hope you guys enjoyed the video tonight. We're ready for tomorrow. Big, big day coming tomorrow morning. I hope I'll see you tomorrow morning in the trade room. If not, come back and see us tomorrow night. We'll do it all again in the next edition of our nightly newsletter. As always, my name is Joseph. Be well out there. Be nice to each other, will ya? Go Dodgers, and we'll see you guys next time. Adios, amigos. Bye-bye for now.